Alright, ladies and gentlemen, Sarge here, and welcome back to the channel for your Wednesday, and today we will be playing this magnificent beast, the Tiger 1 hammer. Now, I do not have, well, alright, so let's just go out with the, we got a request from Carl Johnson. He says, T29/Tiger 1. Well, I don't have a T29, nor do I have the regular Tiger 1. There's actually three Tiger variants in the game. There's Tiger 1 Hammer, there's Tiger 1, and then there's Tiger 131. So, yeah, this is the only variant I have at the moment. So we'll be playing this beast today, this German, big German piece of armor. Legendary, absolute legendary tank during the war, but not so much during World of Tanks. The armor of this thing was impenetrable by anything of the war, by the early war at least. The 6-pounder gun mounted on Sherman Fireflies were the only thing that could reliably, maybe, penetrate the front armor straight on. Anything else would bounce off harmlessly, and all Tigers were almost invincible. Of course, if they got overran by multiple Shermans, they would get flanked from the side where the armor is thinner at the rear and sides of the tank. But in World of Tanks, we're not facing Shermans, we're not facing T-34s, we're facing T-29s, we're facing KV-3s, Tiger P's, you know, shit like that, that has way more penetration than the armor. So, in a way, World of Tanks has nerfed the Tiger in its known ability during the war, because you're facing, you know, post-World War II tanks that were designed to destroy this thing, that it didn't historically face. But that's World Tanks for you. You get all kinds of scenarios that don't work out. It's not supposed to be historical accuracy. Go play War Thunder if that's what you want to play. But anyway, without further ado, let's get straight into the action. This tank is not good for up front. It's not your traditional heavy tank. You stay back and snipe with this thing. Got the long 88. Let's get straight into it. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, here we are on Pearl River. And we are top tier in this amazing tier 7 game. What's up, T29? Our major enemy, T29, by far the best tier 7 heavy tank in the game. Don't argue with me, you will lose. It has the most penetration it has just comedic penetration. It has great hull down capabilities, its turret armor is immaculate. It has good maneuverability, it's got everything. Well, not absolutely everything, the hull armor is not good. You can find hold down places on most of the maps. But anyway, we're playing a Tiger 1 today, ladies and gentlemen. Tier 7 game. So in these types of games, we can actually get in close and up close and personal, except with Onis. Onis will fuck us over. There are a lot of tier 8s. So we need to be careful on where our placement is. By the way, I forgot to say it in the intro, let me know down in the comment section below what tank you would like to see next. I will definitely do whatever tank y'all want me to see. I'm here for you guys. I am doing this for you, not me. I don't make any money. I'm a really small channel, so I really have nothing to gain except for your approval. So come on down to the Sarge Gaming comment section and let me know what y'all want to see me play. Into it. We have okay gun depression, but we need to be careful up in here. They usually come down there at that floating corner down there. Not good with the Tiger. Better with the Tiger P, you know, something with a little bit better armor. Only have 100 at the front, it's all flat armor. What do we got with us? Oh yes, an Oni. I'm going to wait patiently here, like most Tigers did during the war. Looks like a lot of the team is concentrating in the middle here. There's a good number of tanks there. If the Oni moves up, I'll move up. Wish I could use, like, binoculars. Focus on this location. Wish I could look around or zoom in somewhere else in a different direction, but I know those guys aren't in my line of sight. I can't see their silhouette. Keep my gun trained on the other location. Oh, the Onis, at least I want to come out and play. If they decide to come out, alright. Let's back up and get some shots in on this Oni here. Side armor's weak. We got that shot in right on the inside drive wheel. Another shot. The only difference between this tank and the Tiger that you can get from the tech tree is I think this thing has 50 more hit points and maybe some minor speed or gun differences. But the Tiger 131 doesn't even have this gun, this long 88 that it historically had. Oh, come on, bro. It actually has, the Tiger 131 has the historically accurate 88mm gun. Like, the gun this thing has right now, this wasn't even mounted on Tigers. Tiger 1s, for that matter. The Tiger 131 gun is the exact same gun. It's the gun you get on the Tier 6 heavies. You know, the lower heavy. Ooh, God, that's scary. But long 88, very good gun, very diverse, you know, good damage output, good accuracy. That was a terrible shot. Good penetration. It's a just an all-around good gun. Ooh, we got fucked. Alright, missed the Nash horn. We can't see you. Virtually no tanks came this way, so we're going to change our position here. Put our focus towards the middle of the map here. We need to... that Nash horn's dead. Never mind. These guys would fall back and let me put some fire into that. Oni is getting pushed around. But the long 88 starts off, you know, not the long 88, but you first get an 88. Depending on what tank you're using, if it's a tank store at tier 6 with the Jagdpanzer 4, you get an 88. And you can have an 88 all the way up to tier 9. I believe the E50 gets an 88. But it's just an all-around good gun. Hell, on the Ferdinand, it's a good gun. Not a great gun, but it's a good gun, and you can rely on it. Everybody's getting killed. We need to move in. Oh, that's a fall and a half there. Don't lose any health, please. Ooh, that was fun. Traverse is not too good, not too vulnerable on these tanks. Need to get in there and. Don't flip over. Physics. Alright. Oh, one tank has been spotted over here. It's a Tiger 131. About dead already, though. I'm going to move in this way and maybe get in behind at least some of the tanks. So I'd like to see more enemies to shoot at. Most of the tanks have been killed already. We got three good hits in. Gotta watch ourselves here. E25 scouting out for us. Good set. If we stayed where we were. Ooh, M4s. Here we go. Here's what we fought in the war. Let's go ahead and fuck these guys up really quick. What's up, dudes? Where you going? Thought you wanted to fight. Oh, right off the turret. So we should have stayed where we were. Those tanks did push on all those friendly tanks we had over there. Surprised they all got killed as easy as they did. But I digress. These two M4s are going to get shit on by my long 88.
Enemies got us in their sights.
Oh, come on. They got the howitzers in. Missed that guy. Ooh. Oh, come on, dude. Get me a break, man. That guy's coming around our ass. Whoa, E25's going in. Dude, if that guy gets a good hit on him with a high explosive, he's dead. Yep, I told you. That was a bad decision making on the E25's part. E25 has no armor. I don't know why you would want to do that. Here he comes. Good hit there. Took a small little peck on the front. Damn, all these low armor tanks rushing this M4 get absolutely shit on. Alright, here goes the Tiger 131. Let's see what he can do. I'm gonna stay back here and just wait till he comes out. I mean, that's a good strat. Yeah, see, look, we can another shot on him. If he wouldn't. Hey, dead. Oh, Neef. Alright, we won. Yeah! Five hits, three track target hits, and one critical, or two criticals, I mean. That's an okay first game. We didn't get shit on, but we didn't do much damage. 1,244. Hard to talk today. Tiger131 doing 2,314 damage. Pretty far down the list. Well, I mean, we didn't get many shots on many tanks. The team just totally roasted everybody. But I digress. Let's get into another battle. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, back on Port Snow. And it is a tier 8 game. There's two tier 8s on our team. They have one tier 8. And that one tier 8 is the Heavy Metal Hero FV305. It's a bird, if I'm not mistaken. And it's a tier 8? FV304. It's an FV305. It has a different gun, I know that much. It's I didn't know it was a tier 8, though. That's interesting. That is really interesting. Where are we going? We need to make sure we stay with teammates. Our traverse is better since it's a snow map. Ooh, it's a Fazalan. And we got an MXM445. Don't lag. Stop. Stop lagging. Alright, guys. We're back after that lag spike. Where are we? We have gotten turned around. I don't know what language you're speaking. We're not in the party anymore because, yeah. Let's get right back into the party. Did I invite only? I do that so I don't hear anybody in game chat. They interrupt me and I don't talk to anybody in game chat, so I interrupt them. But anyway, I digress. Looks like our team has progressed pretty far down this left flank. We're going to try to catch up with them. They've already killed four tier 7 tanks. That's pretty lit. Pretty lit. Wish we were up there with them. Would've been a hell of a lot better battle. That FV305 must have a lot of range. He's still sitting back there. Definitely has a really big gun. We're almost back up with our teammates here. They're fucking up this Tiger 1. I want to get some shots in on Tiger P. I want to do some damage this game, man. Can't do it when I lag out like that. And he's already dead. But. Alright. Well, excuse me. Go. That was an artillery shot. Artillery down that way. Really want to get some damage in this game. I haven't even looked at a tank yet. Artillery spotted. Oh, it's the FV. Yeah. That thing's fucking huge. It's like a Burt just enlarged, just fucking ginormous Burt. I'd like to put them against each other and see who would win. Let's just see how big this motherfucker is. Yeah, this thing is huge. As big as me! That's insane! Insanity, dude. Definitely has a bigger gun, you can tell by the length of it. Trying to get in here and do some damage, man. I really want to get some damage. Oh, it's a 2.9. Hit that inside driver. Backed off before we could get a shot at him. Push forward. I want to get some damage done. Our team is just steamrolling everybody, and we can't get in to do any damage fast enough. Come on, bro. Well, they changed up this map a lot. Used to be train tracks going through here. Now it's nothing. Just a bunch of buildings. Which I guess makes for a little bit better gameplay. Will we stop killing everybody? I want to do some damage. Black Prince. Be able to go right through his front. Oh, he's angled now. Good shot there. On that flat part of his upper glacis. Don't get in front of me, please. Penetrate that. Yes, we can. One more shot and he's down. Alright. Tiger P. Here for that command hatch. Really weak point. I hated getting shot there. Pull up, dude. Ah, oh, fuck. Three shots in the whole game. Come on, dude. Like, we could do a lot more, but our team just steamrolls everybody. That happens in some games. It just seems like, you know, you could do really good, but your team steamrolls everybody and you can't get up there to do any damage, or your team gets steamrolled and once you get there, you get fucked up. Alright, boys, we are back on Teepville Ridge, and it's an encounter battle, and we are extremely top tier. There's only a couple tier 7s on each team. Let's not fuck this up. Let's make this a high damage, really good game, because the last two games have been just not bad, but how do I explain it? I don't know how to explain it. I don't know what word am I looking for. Put down in the comment section below what word I would be looking for to describe the last two games. Mediocre? No, that's like medium. It wasn't medium. That was like just boring, almost. That medium is really getting stuck in. I don't want to get too stuck in. We're like really top tier, but our armor still can't hold up against a lot of these tanks. Because our armor just isn't good enough for the type of tanks we're facing here. We're gonna get into some real deep shit if we get up to what medium is. We're pretty slow. Not nearly as fast as that medium, but their spawn is right behind that mountain that medium's on. KV-1, easy pickings for my gun. As well for that Tiger 1. Dead as hell. I'm gonna get up here with some medium to support him. Strength in numbers is always appreciated. M4 killed a Churchill 1. I actually want to go this way. Handbrake turn. Nice. Nice. M44 took out the KV-1. So we both lost a heavy tank.
Focus on this area.
Both tier 5s. Hope we don't see a shit ton of shit coming down this road here. Oh, artillery spotted. It's a gorilla. He's down. One shot there. Wrong neighborhood. Now, whoever is around this corner knows I'm here, so I'm not going to be surprising anybody, but maybe they're low tier and I can just fuck them up. Should we angle our armor good around this corner? Nothing spotted. There's a lot of the enemy team over there, but I don't want to poke out here. Nothing? Let's go to T-25. It's gonna scout out the right flank. There should be more arties up here. This is the arty spawn, looks like. There's nothing coming down from this way. Should be able to sweep around and get the guys from behind if our team doesn't completely destroy them like they had the last two games. Team too good. Team too good. What's bouncing off of him? That light tank. Yeah, MT-25. Hold on, comrade. We are slow. We're going to kill SU-14. Just got tracked by something. Oh, hello. He's down. Let's focus on this MT-25. Knows we're here now. He shouldn't be doing this. Wrong neighborhood. Stop capping. Hit his engine. He's got APCR loaded. Boom! That did nothing. One hit point more. Wow. Let's crest over this ridge and see if there's any tanks coming back to support there already. Now that light tank would have spotted them by now. Keep pushing forward. We need to come in behind these guys. It's 6-6, so it's tie game. How did that... What is that shot? Oh, here we go. We got snipes on these boys.
We got him.
This guy's AFK. These guys are both AFK.
Punched a hole in their armor.
He's down. Let's wait for the spot on that on the TD. There he is.
Penetration.
And Morak shot towards the back. Reload is pretty fast, pretty good damage output.
That one drilled straight through.
We get the kill on him. Nope. That's alright. We got track target hits on both of those shots that hit. It's like the rest of the remaining forces are towards the middle where the base is. Looks like exactly where the rest of the forces are. Maybe there's one up towards the north. It's a heavy tank. I'm not sure which heavy tank. There's the hammer. It's gotta be the Black Prince. Black Prince went all the way across the map. That thing is slow as balls. Where's that light? It's a chap. Peanut alarm! They're both up there, trying to pick on our arties. We got a lot more hits than we did the last two games. We got 3 kills. I will definitely take it. 2 of them arties. We're not going to be able to get back in time to do any more damage, I don't think, unless they come to us. Huh? Oh, fall damage. Yeah. So, the reason we didn't die today, at least once, is because we didn't get placed in a tier 9, or I wouldn't consider that last game to be a tier 8 battle. We didn't get placed. We were top tier more often. Like, we were top tier every game, basically. I mean, there were tier 8s in that one game, but there weren't enough to make a difference. So, that's why we didn't get killed today. The Tiger can get roasted really fast by tier 9s and 8s. Trust me. I've played the Tiger long ago. Long ago, I took a vow. But the Tiger is just... It's definitely not as good as it's made up to be. Handbrake turn for the win. Yeah!
That's how you do it.
Good victory, guys. Good victory. 15-9 to finish it out. See what damage we did. Pretty good amount of damage. All 3 of these. Those XP rewards? Oh, fuck, they are. Damn it. Third class mastery badge. A sniper medal. That's the kind of medals you want to be getting this thing. 1,893 damage. Top of the team. Let's go, boys. So long 88, especially on the Tiger, is really good for sniping. You want to stay back. You want to hit as many targets as you can from long range. If you get close enough, they're going to be able to spot you. Going to be able to penetrate you because your armor is not good. Not nearly as good as any other tier 7 heavy tank. At least, maybe, probably better than the French, if I had to guess. But lots of damage output, lots of penetration, good accuracy. Just a perfect sniping gun on a heavy tank, which people are going to lay into you for staying back in a heavy tank, but, you know, like I did last video, but those guys were made to be up front. Like, Russian tanks are made to be up front. They're not snipers whatsoever. Accuracy is no good, comrade. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed Carl Johnson, this video. Did get into your request. Hope you enjoyed the Tiger 1 hammer. Let me know down in the comment section below what you all want to see on Friday. On Monday, we will be doing some ranked battle litness. So make sure you tune into that. And I believe that's a wrap, guys. Have a great, great hump day. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Like the video if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you're new. I'm Sarge. Signing out.